after the first 6 years. Second, after the 10 years, when we have one of all Singapore, Cambridge, all levels. And thirdly, after 12 years, I'm also pursuing more academic plans to have a Singapore, Cambridge, A-levels. So these are three major national exams, in between in the school-based exams.
Yeah, so it's a requirement for them to graduate, to move up. And
that's right, because once you get to the secondary school stage, every school is a selective school. Every single school is a selective school, which also means that any child in any primary school, no matter where they stay and who their parents are, they have a choice to go to any secondary school they want in the country based on their performance in the national exam.
So because we also have streamlines, does it mean that the exam is going to be different from each stream, from each
ranking? It used to be. But now at the primary school level, it is increasingly, it is a common exam. But some students who are very weak in certain subjects are allowed to take a foundation level exam, which is at a lower level with less content. And we find a way of weighting the grades appropriately to allow them to progress as well.
Does the student only have one opportunity to pass the test, or do you have multiple opportunities?
For the primary school, we allow for repeat, for someone to repeat the final year. But now we have created special schools at the secondary school stage. I mentioned earlier on, specialized independent schools that provide a vocational path. For those who fail their primary school leaving examination, the national examination, for those who fail once, we'd like to encourage them to consider the school. For those who fail twice, we especially encourage them to consider this alternative path so they can go on and not drop out.
You have 6 years in primary.
That's right.
They can move on.
This is why we created these new schools
on the side,
independent and providing a more vocational path.
But first, the student need to take several times first before
It used to be that you need to fail twice first.
Only twice.
Now, if you fail once, we still encourage you to consider. Those who fail, even failing their foundation subjects, they really need a different method of education altogether.
Much more hands-on learning. Do you have the test by the end of the 6 years, or because it allows
end of 6 years?
The end.
It's at the end of 6 years. There's no repeats along the way, but along the way, those who are very weak in the last 2 years of the 6 years, they're allowed to take a simpler subject, which we call a foundation subject.
So if they feel that after 2 years, what they have going to do? So in Indonesia, we have to follow package B and package E and also C. So what in Singapore to do?
So firstly, within the mainstream school system, there is a technical school for those who are weaker, but they must still pass the examination in primary school. For those who fail completely, we have now created special schools on the side of the mainstream. One is called Northlight, the other one is called Assumption Pathway School. And these are both new schools, they're new models, which are catching a lot of excitement in fact. A lot of attention, a lot of private sector people are coming in to support them because they're providing a very different environment and method of learning. And personally, I'm very excited by these two schools.
How long is the duration between the first and the second test? If they fail, the test?